Google Calendar is full of amazing features, but are you being as productive as you can be with gCal? In this video, I'm sharing 5 Google Calendar tips for productivity that will help streamline your gCal experience and save you time. Hey friends, I'm Tasia and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a whole bunch of Google tips. Today, we are diving back into Google Calendar 2021, but this time we're focusing on Google Calendar tips for productivity, and we have a whole lot to cover, so let's go. So if you are familiar with me and my channel, hi, welcome back, good to see you. You know I've covered a lot of Google Calendar tips over the years, and I have linked to all of those videos below, so if you want even more gCal goodness, be sure to check out all the links below. So tip number one, create a new event quickly using shortcuts. You know how much I love shortcuts to save time. From either your Chrome browser or Safari, simply type cal.new into the browser bar and blammo, a new tab with a blank calendar event is launched. This is gonna open up a new event tab for whichever account you've logged into, by the way. So if you have multiple Google accounts, just keep that in mind. Now you might think that browser shortcut looks familiar, and you'd be right. I have covered a similar shortcut before for Sheets, Slides, and Docs, and that video is the Google Drive video listed below as well. Now on to gCal tip number 2, and that's to add invisible events to your Google Calendar. This is particularly helpful if you share a calendar with others, but you only want to create an event that's visible to you and not them. From your gCal, click to create your event. Once you've titled it whatever it is that you want, head to this visibility section here. It's the section with your calendar name. Go ahead and click on that and set your availability to free. Then set your default visibility to private. Setting the event visibility to free just ensures that that particular time slot still shows publicly as available, regardless of what you've put privately in there. So it's just you that sees your 15-minute stretch session or whatever it is that you do in the privacy of your own Google Calendar. No judgment. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a like. It helps signal YouTube that you do find value in this content. Tip number 3, change the default event reminder time and notification type. You can easily change this by heading to your settings. So head to the gear icon and select settings. From here, select your calendar under settings for my calendars option. It's on the left-hand side here. Now scroll down and under event notifications, click add notification if you don't have that set up yet. Then from here, you can just adjust the default time and also the type of notification. So if you rather receive an email, you could choose that here, as well as whatever number of either minutes, hours, days, or weeks. By the way, any changes you make here will be auto-saved for you. Tip number 4, set up a daily agenda email. This is one I've talked about before and I use it 100%, but it is worth mentioning again because if you have a lot going on and you just want to see a quick snapshot of what you have coming up for the day, this is for you. So to do this, we're going to head back to that settings section in gCal. And again, you want to select your calendar from the left-hand side. Then either scroll down or just select event notifications here. Now here, under other notifications, right where it says daily agenda, make sure this is set to email. Now you'll receive an email first thing in the morning, I think it's 5 a.m., with your schedule for the day. And here's an example of one of those emails. Tip number 5, search for Google Calendar events. If you have a terrible memory like I do, and you need to quickly bring up an event that happened in the past, but you can't really remember all the details, or maybe you know you have an event coming up, this tip is money. From your gCal, click the search icon in the top right, and a search bar is going to appear at the top, which, sure, that's great and all, but if you click the arrow to the right of the search bar, you'll bring up all kinds of advanced search options. So you can search in all your active calendars or select a specific calendar to search in. You can add keywords from the event title, other participants, where the event was, or even rough date outlines. So if you know it happened in 2020, but you really can't remember when, you could add that here. Then just hit search, and gCal will bring up any and all events that match those search criteria. So if you notice anything else really cool in my gCal while you've watched this video, it's most likely that I've covered that before in those other videos, which are linked in my description below. That's really all there is to it. Now I want to hear from you. What do you think about these Google Calendar productivity tips? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I want to know, so give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here and here for even more Google Calendar content. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.